We have a leak, a cyber attack, no less.
What has been leaked?
Hackers intercepted our people's email, calling Chinese and American trade official tedious.
How can we quietly resolve the problem?
Let EU computer emergency response team handle it.
Great, I knew the Maastricht Treaty would come in handy.
Our priority is to ensure a bulletproof solidarity.
But the leak can cause a cataclysmic diplomatic episode with the US and China, a rift in our security, and make us a laughingstock in the front pages.
How do you suggest we proceed then?
Like we always do, through lengthy, tiresome, and fruitless discussions.
Are you implying we're bureaucratic?
Ah, perish the thought.
We ought to leave things to the EU administrators, who know how to diligently delay matters until the press and other states are too bored to wait for an immediate action from us.
Alas, to give up our national sovereignty and allow some Europol commission to take over and handle things?
Yes, we call it diplomacy.
Giving control of our government decision to Brussels? This is political suicide.
May I remind you that we are in Brussels and our big fat salaries are paid by Brussels?
Still, as heads of state, we will deny all knowledge and have our bureaucrats take the blame. Besides, for them, it's occupational hazard.
But isn't this moral?
Oh, you're an idealist. It's all about securing European stability.
Besides, when this is over, we'll simply take credit for resolving it.
But isn't Maastricht about celebrating and affirming solidarity?
Well, only when it suits us.
Do we inform the public about the cyber crisis?
Who should decide? Who got it wrong and fed it to the devouring world press and social media?
Well, I do not think we should. The issue hasn't matured yet.
Now, that thought is not worthy of you. There's such thing as integrity, you know.
I think you're too taken aback by your own political balcony speeches. What we say to the voters and what we do are two different things.
What this cyber crisis told us is how to defend the indefensible.
This puts a different complexion.
Isn't there a wind of change in Europe?
Yes, we redrafted the redraft of the draft of the security policy, having always in mind the preservation of the European solidarity.
To say things with tact and finesse.
What about the principle of openness in our affairs?
Well, let's just say there seems to be close season for openness. What I'm saying is that we adopt a more flexible posture to our solidarity values.
It is a tough decision, but a necessary one, if we're to appear compassionate. Now, I envision solidarity as pulling strings and exercising tighter control.
I envision solidarity as the EU solidarity policeman.
Solidarity, you finding our projects.
Envisioning solidarity, seeking freedom from EU riding.
I envision solidarity. How to glue solidarity?